In this video, we're gonna see if my $500 gamble paid off. We're gonna try like crazy to get that old crusty Nova running and driving again under its own power, even though it's been sitting completely untouched for the last 24 years. We filmed a video about rescuing this car and then bringing it home and digging through it and looking through all the junk that's inside of it and figuring out exactly what this thing is, because when I bought it, I didn't even know what year it was. I didn't know what engine it had in it. Didn't know its condition, just basically bought this thing sight unseen. And I gave $500 for it and an engine and a bunch of parts. So I felt pretty good about it. It was kind of a gamble, it still is, but we're gonna see if we can get this thing running, and that'll make me feel much better about my investment. And it's important to note that this is a small block Chevrolet. This is tried and true, easy engine to work on. These things are really dependable. Most of the time you can get them running fairly easily, especially of this generation, because it has electronic ignition. So since this thing has a two barrel carburetor, that means that it's more than likely a 305, because I looked it up on the internet. The 350s that were available in the Novas were four barrel only. So unless somebody's changed that intake and carburetor, we're probably looking at a 305. So we'll see what we get into on this thing. It's been sitting forever. It's had stuff living in it. There's no telling what's been done to the wiring. We don't know exactly what's up with it. And there was a reason this thing was parked 20 something years ago. So we don't know what that reason was. It could have been a transmission out, could have been brake issues, could have been a catastrophic engine issue that we don't know about. We're gonna find all that stuff out right here, right now. So even though there's bigger things I probably need to be working on, it's driving me crazy that this thing is sitting here on flat tires. So I'm gonna try to get these tires to air up, and the ones that I can't get to air up, I'm gonna switch them out just so that this thing is sitting up and sitting level. It's just bugging me sitting here like this. Looks like we're out of luck on this right front tire. It's just not wanting to hold air. It kind of sounds like it's coming out of the backside around the bead. I can't really tell because I can't get my head under there, but probably just gonna jack this thing up, put the spare tire on here. It looks a little rough. I mean, the tire itself is slick as it can be, but I think it'll hold air enough for us to get this thing up off the ground.
All right, let's see what it takes to get this wheel off of here. I don't know how these caps attach. Really don't want to break them. Aha. Oh yeah. Yes. Oh yes. Gonna miss a lug nut. It saves me some time. Okay. Got those broke loose. That's not sketchy.
And as you can see, I've got all five lug nuts off of there, and this wheel is stuck onto that hub. From where it's been sitting all these years, the rust is kind of built up around the hub and the center of the wheel. And just take a hammer and a little bit of persuasion, we can beat this thing off of there. It looks like this steel wheel and spare tire is fitting on there okay, but I want to make sure that it's clearing that disc brake caliper, because some of these 14-inch wheels will not clear disc brakes. All right, this left rear, there's no chance of it holding air, so I'm going to go ahead and change it out. Luckily, I've got a spare tire and wheel that came out of my 64 Chevelle. Now, this is one of those 14-inch wheels that will not clear a disc brake caliper, so I'm putting it on the back. Should clear this drum brake with no problem whatsoever. Now, this ratty steel wheel and white wall tire looks terrible on this car, but what's even worse is a tire that's completely flat. That absolutely takes all of my motivation away. If I see a car that's got flat tires on it, I don't want to fool with it. I don't want to work on it. So that was step one, getting this thing up on tires to where I feel good about making the next step.
I thought I had a good plan, but the old rim, rusty. Yeah, that air coming out. I need to see if it's got any cooling in it. Looks pretty dry. Looks like there's something down in there, but I can't tell if it's green or just water. Hopefully it's got some antifreeze in it. That would be handy. Okay. All right, we need to check the oil. Let's go ahead and check transmission fluid while we're just messing around. Okay, it's got some. Ooh. Ooh, that smells burnt. It smells very burnt. Okay. Let's check some oil. Oil. It's not very dark. Doesn't smell like gas. That's a good thing. It's not milky. Okay. Well, that's good. We need to get this off. Let's see if it's got any brake fluid in it at all. It's got some. Nothing in the back. A little bit in the front. Super yucky. Just set that there for a minute. I use nothing but the best .3 brake fluid from the dollar store in my vehicles. Get a little bit there. Let's get a little bit here. Just a splash. A little bit. A little more. Okay. This thing probably just not try very hard with that. Crunchy, very crunchy. Okay. So it'd probably be a good idea to pull the plugs out and squirt this thing full of some kind of something, PB blaster, some oil, but I'm gonna skip a few steps here and just see if this engine will turn over. I've got a 5/8 socket and breaker bar. Again, this is probably not the best first step, but it's what I'm gonna do. It'll give me a pretty quick answer. All I'm looking for is a little nudge. Here. Okay, we need to see if this carburetor is freed up to where it'll, oh yeah, that's good. Choke is hung open, which is okay. That's a good thing. This thing's got a ton of vacuum lines that'll need to be replaced. I'm sure they're all dry rotted.
All this stuff's probably got to be replaced. But I think my next step is putting a hot battery, pouring a little bit of gas, and we'll see what happens. I don't know. Hopefully the starter's good. I haven't checked any kind of wiring or anything like that.
This car had a battery in it already, and it was already hooked up and everything, but it was completely dead. I did roll my battery charger out there to it, hooked it up, didn't get much action out of that. So I ended up robbing the battery out of my other Nova and set it over in there just to try to see what I'm up against here. See if the ignition switch works, see if I can get any power to anything.
All right, luckily we got some keys with this car and hooked up the battery. I'm gonna see if this thing will turn over. I don't wanna hurt anything, I'm just gonna bump it and see if it spins the motor at all. Okay, I actually heard one of those speakers back there. Huh, okay, we got some lights on the dash. It's a good sign. Please tell me this radio works.
.com. The top of the hour is presented by Best Buy Metals, making sure the top of your house is the best it can be.
Yeah.
BestBuyMetalRoofing.com.
We've got a radio. Okay, we got to watch that fan blade and see if it moves at all. Nope, I got nothing. Okay. Well, the good news is we've got a radio. That means we can plug in that Leonard Skinner tape. All right, so fast forward a little bit. I pulled the starter off of this thing, and I rigged up a little way to test this while it's off of the car where I can actually get to it. I couldn't really get much in there as far as trying to short out the two posts on the starter to just force it to turn. So I went ahead and got the starter out of there. I'm gonna test it now. I've got my booster cables hooked up to my hot battery, running right over here, grounding it over here on the starter. We got the hot side on the hot side, as well as this jumper wire, which is not really much of a jumper. This is just a scrap ground wire that I had. So what I'm gonna do is touch, we're basically jumpering from one terminal to the next, and we're gonna see if this thing spins over. If it does, that means our starter's good, and we got a wiring problem. Okay, gonna touch that. Oh, yep, we got action. Yep, it's doing what it's supposed to do. Okay, well there's that. I guess I can put that starter back in, start tracing down some wires. While I was under here fooling with the starter, I started looking at some of the fuel system stuff, and I see this hose is pretty rotten. Even the hose clamps are rotten, and there's a big hole right here. So that pretty much eliminates our ability to use the factory tank. Wasn't thinking we could do that anyway, so we'll have to rig up a temporary fuel system. All right, so we weren't getting any juice over to the starter, so I decided first easiest place to look is the neutral safety switch. That's what keeps your vehicle from cranking up while it's in drive or reverse. Well, you can bypass that by just putting a little jumper wire from one terminal of this plug-in to the other. And we're gonna give that a try. See if that helps anything. If it does, that means our neutral safety switch is bad, and we'll just keep it bypassed for the time being. So, all right, let's try this again. Key on, we got juice, we got radio. Let's listen for anything, any good action out here. Yes, okay. All right, we got starter, the engine's turning over. We're one step closer to trying to crank this thing up.
So after bypassing that neutral safety switch, I ended up pouring a little bit of gas down the carburetor just to see if this thing would try to hit. I could have done a lot of different tests to be able to see if I had spark, but I'm not patient. I wanted to pour some gas in there, see if the thing would just try to hit, so I could know what that next step was gonna be.
Okay, well that was easy. So now what we're gonna do is make up a fuel system out of my gas can. I'm gonna hook it up to that fuel pump right down here. Just gonna hook a hose up to it.
Not sure that that fuel pump's gonna work. It's been sitting a long time. We're gonna try it and see if it'll pull some gas up into that carburetor. The moment this thing turned over, it was pretty much ready to run. So pretty excited about that. That is, I didn't even pump the gas or nothing. I mean, that was just turn it over and it was good. Now I do see some smoke. You see that smoke? That's not good. We gotta figure out where that's coming from. Okay, the ignition switch is off. Okay, I'm not seeing any smoke anymore. Maybe it fixed itself. Right, this might be the most redneck thing I've ever done. I didn't have a long enough piece of 3/8 hose, but I did have this little tube, which is originally for an oil dipstick, and it's kind of 3/8 ish, and I got this one side on there. I'm gonna get the other side slid on there, and that'll make a long enough piece to connect to my gas tank. Fuel system is installed. Get that line run in there. Let's see if it works. Now, the wasps are angry. So angry right now. Okay, excuse me. Okay, we're getting close. Give it a couple of pumps. Try again. I'm gonna give it one more drink. So every time I splash a little bit of gas down the carburetor, this thing fires right up, but it only runs on that little splash of gas. Fire up and run for a second and then die. And you know, every time in between, I'm pouring a little bit more gas down the carburetor and just hoping that if it runs long enough, that it'll start pulling some of that gas out of that jug. man, I cannot believe it. This thing finally picked up and it's running like a champion. This thing, I don't know if it's got oil pressure or not. I'm assuming it does, but no smoke, no real action other than this thing running for the first time in over 20 years. I cannot believe how easy this thing fired up. Now this thing sounds pretty ratty, and that's because the exhaust rotted off of it probably 20 years ago. But it does still have the original catalytic converter on it, so that's muffling the sound down a little bit, but you can hear it's a little louder than it should be. But I think it's running on all 8 cylinders. You know, there's no real drama anywhere there. This thing sounds pretty promising. I'm excited to see if it'll move under its own power.
All right, I've got my test course set up here. Got a Scotch on the front side. Got a little bit of room here to give myself some room to see if this thing will take gear. We're about to find out. Bit of transmission fluid. I didn't have a lot. We're gonna see if that helped anything at all. This thing fires right up. I cannot believe it. It sits there and idles. Brake pedal is real hard. Not sure if I'm gonna have brakes or not. Let's see. All right, I went to the parts store and got me about 10 feet of 3/8 hose. I got my gas tank. We're gonna put it somewhere. Oh, oops. Let's see. How about right there? Yeah, it works. Now, we install the fuel line. Got it. Okay, and done. That's good. This will be good. Okay. We got some brake issues. Brakes are not working. I cracked the lines open, pumped the brakes up. No fluid is passing through here. So that's telling me that something is seized up in the back of the master cylinder. If it's not moving fluid at all, there's something big time wrong. So we'll take a look right here. This should tell us what's happening. We should be able to watch that little nub right there and see it move when we push the brake pedal. Looks like that part of it's working. It's something seized up, probably in the back side of the master cylinder, so we'll go ahead and pull it off of there. All right, I don't know if this is gonna work, this was my only option without buying a new master cylinder. So this piston would not come all the way back up. And so I didn't have any other way to grab it. So I got the little snap ring out of there. I drilled a hole right there, put like a wood deck screw in there. And now I'm going to pull that piston out and see if I can do something to slick up this bore or the piston so that this thing will move back and forth again. Got it. Whew. All right. Success.
So after I wasted a bunch of time on that crusty old master cylinder, I realized it was a lost cause, and I went to the local parts store. They had a master cylinder in stock for this thing. It was about 50 bucks. It needs a lot of other brake attention as well. I'm sure that it needs hoses and that it needs calipers and that it needs a lot of attention. But we're going to try to at least get this thing down the road with just the new master cylinder.
Fill it up with some fresh fluid and hope that the calipers aren't frozen up and that the brake hoses are okay. A lot of hoping going on there. Lid on it, and then we're gonna see if we can get some brakes to pop up. Yeah.
Are you okay?
No brake pedal yet. Not good. You hop in there and give it a try. Check for leaks and anything like that. I don't see any leaks. So before we try to run it very much, we need to get a little bit of water so it doesn't run too hot. Thirsty.
She dehydrated.
Yes.
Very, 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 very dehydrated.
That's what happens when you sit for 24, 25 years, something like that.
Yeah.
That ought to be enough to do what we need to do. We'll come back and make sure it's topped off once we run it a little bit and circulate it.
Okay. Here you go.
Thank you. So we're gonna close this hood down carefully.
So you don't
mess up our fuel system here.
Yeah, we got no fuel tank, so.
Wrap this so it doesn't pinch it. Close it to it. Maybe that'll be better.
That's a good idea. Okay. Nice. Can I ride with you?
Let me scoop some of this stuff out of the way.
Yeah, why is this here?
Classic Performance Products, CPP.
CPP.
Okay. This should protect you from
any
whatever's
stains
living in here. Yeah.
And stain.
Yeah, I Hop in there. Hop back out. Lots of bees.
Yeah.
We've disturbed the bees again.
Get the wasp spray.
Nice and easy. Good. All right, go ahead and get in.
I get to smell the gasoline.
Yay.
We all get to smell the gasoline.
Can't believe how easy this thing cranks up. Like, it's unbelievable. I mean, it's sitting there idle. I'm so proud. Okay, let's see. My brake pedal is still way down on the floor. But let's see if I got brakes.
Test drive it?
Ooh, not very good brakes. Not very good. We do need a little bit more transmission fluid. Let's do that real quick before we take off.
Okay.
All right, we're running again. We topped off the transmission fluid, I think. We're going to give these brakes a try. Okay, still took a little while to get down into reverse.
Is this gonna work?
Yeah. I'm not actually.
I am. You think it's gonna work?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dude.
Let's try it.
Alright.
try. Let's hope that these brakes don't lock up.
And then we're
the wheel doesn't fall off. Or that bee doesn't sting us.
Yeah, all those things.
Okay.
So
moving. Far, so good. We're moving. It's a little bit scary. This tire is almost completely flat already.
And we literally just came to there. Our neighbor.
Mr. Terry.
Couldn't tell by the huge smile on my face while I was driving this piece of junk. I'm pretty excited. I'm fired up. I spent $100 getting this thing running. So I ended up buying some fuel hose, which is more expensive than it should be. I ended up buying a master cylinder, some brake fluid, some transmission fluid, and by the time you add all that up, it's about $100. So $500 for the car, $100 for the get it running again kit, and this thing runs surprisingly good. Now, I know that it can run better, and I'm gonna work on that. So be sure to follow along, hit the subscribe button if you like this type of video, because I wanna keep doing stuff on this car and on other cars and other projects that we bring in here, because this is what we do. Now, a lot of my content previously has been about drag car documentaries, old car collections and old junkyards and things like that, and I'm gonna continue doing that type of content, but I'm gonna work in these personal projects as they come along because they're fun. I can include my kids in it, and we just have a good time with this. So I thought you guys might enjoy following along with this project. The next time you see this car, we're gonna be giving this thing a complete makeover. We're gonna clean the outside of it. We're gonna see what our true potential is here with this car. So stay tuned. Thank you for all the support, and thank you for watching.